I'm Kurusa Brahmakumari.
And I'm Abigail Graham.
Welcome to the Wednesday, May 19th edition of the GoFundMe Show.
Our lunch choices for today are PB&J sandwich, smoothie combo, hamburger or cheeseburger, fruit and milk. Our breakfast choices for Thursday, May 20th are sweet cinnamon waffle, smoothie, fruit and milk. The lunch choices for Thursday, May 20th are PB&J sandwich, grilled chicken salad, macaroni and cheese, fruit and milk.
Today's high will reach new 88 degrees and mostly sunny.
Here is the history of DVDs.
In 1986, Warner Home Video executive Warren Weaverfold began urging Japanese consumer electronics makers to create an optical disc technology designed to store memories in hope that such a format would entice consumers to buy movies as opposed to renting them. During the early 1990s, many partnerships were made and broken as companies worked to create their own formats, such as Sony's multimedia compact disc and Tabisha's super density SD digital video disc. In 1995, a group of IT companies led by IBM executive Alan E. Bell created the digital versatile disc, DVD.
In 1997, Warner announced its first 30 DVD titles, which included movies like Blade Runner, Casablanca, and Twister. By 1998, approximately 1.4 million U.S. homes had DVDs, DVD players, and DVD revenue hit $350 million that same year. That same year, Netflix was founded as an online DVD rental service. In 1999, Blockbuster rolled out the ability to rent DVDs. By 2006, however, revenue from DVD rentals and sales flattened out at around $24 billion, while rival formats, HD DVDs and Blu-ray debuted. Today, streaming services are the most popular way to watch movies, but DVDs are still bought and sold.
Happy birthday today to Aubrey J in 4th grade and Mia S in kindergarten.
Students may be testing. Please watch for the red signs and walk quietly when traveling outside your classroom.
Remember to be safe, brave, responsible, and respectful.
Thank you for watching.
Have a great Gopher Day!